Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for being with us today. First thing I'd like to do is remind you that I do a publication. It's called Beth's Newfangled Family Tree. It's absolutely free. It's on electricscotland.com. It's https://electricscotland.com/B for Beth's, N for newfangled, T for tree, sorry, let me start. B for Beth's, N for newfangled, F for family, and T for tree, Beth's Newfangled Family Tree. You'll not only find the latest editions that are done to this point, you'll find an archives from 2007 till now. Lots of goodies for you to enjoy, I hope. Today we're going to talk about epidemics and genealogy. Throughout human history, peoples all across the world have been ravaged by epidemics. While most of these occurred prior to our modern advances in medicine, there are many parts of the third world today that still endure these tragedies on a regular basis. Historically, when these unfortunate events occur, entire towns and families are wiped out. In many cases, due to the fear of spreading disease, the remains were burned quickly. Little, if any, effort was made to document the names of the deceased. The United States has faced its share of epidemics throughout our history. Two of the most severe were the yellow fever outbreak that swept through the South in 1841 and the infamous 1918 Spanish flu outbreak, which quickly throughout the world eventually hit the United States. This latter epidemic claimed the lives of an estimated 25 to 40 million people. Our ancestors had a much shorter lifespan than modern medicine has allowed our current generations to enjoy. Two of the most common causes of death were wars and epidemics. If you encounter a situation where a large number of your ancestors or residents of a given locality disappeared during a certain time period, and there is no evidence of any war-related explanation, an epidemic is a strong possibility. If an epidemic occurred within a given community, an event of this magnitude could be mentioned in any published county histories for the locality or region. The local health department of the community in question would be another source for information. Epidemics have played major roles throughout human history. Many cases of people disappearing from records can be traced to dying during an epidemic or moving away from the affected regions. And as sad as it is, someday the pandemic that we have all lived through so far is going to be one of these that causes much, much grief as time goes on as well. Thank you so much for joining us today. We'll see you next time.